Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. I'm available for code reviews and on-site training. Now, in this episode, I want to talk about decltype auto, and I will start by saying that I originally planned to cover much more than I'm actually going to now, because I just really want to tell you like what the point of decltype auto is, where it can help, without going into too many details. I would like to thank UltraEdit for sponsoring today's episode of C++ Weekly. UltraEdit is a modern, full-featured programmer's editor with all the features that we've come to expect from an editor, but considerably less memory overhead than you might be used to from your current JavaScript-based code editor. UltraEdit has been around since 1994, and they are experts in building tools for programmers. Now, besides all of the goodness that we want, like structured JSON file editing, hex editing, live markdown preview, syntax highlighting, and very large file support, UltraEdit also includes UltraCompare, a powerful diff tool with binary diffs, structured table diffs, PDF diffs, directory diffs, and three-way text file diffs. And this is only scratching the surface. Be sure to check out this video's description for links on how to learn more about the full suite of tools that UltraEdit offers. Okay, so what we need to first mention is just the general idea of decltype auto. It deduces the exact type of an expression. So let's just go ahead and make, well, code that I hope you would never write. So you can play a little game here if you want to and test yourself along the way. And the question is, what is the type of I? I'll slowly type in the answer. So as we can see here with this compile time check, I is an int. And if we go through a few iterations of this, if I explicitly say I want it to be a const int, then I have to get a const int. Well, I'm implicitly saying I want a const int by doing const auto. So if I put a reference here, then this is going to be deduced as a reference. Now, if I remove this const, then we can see that the type is still const int reference. Now, if you haven't watched my previous episode on how auto works, you should go watch that. It has the same rules as template parameter deduction. So auto is not going to ever deduce a reference. But if I were to have done decltype auto, then I'm going to get a const int reference because the result of the expression of calling get value is a const int reference. So decltype auto deduces the exact type of an expression. It's really useful in generic code when you need to know, for whatever reason, the exact type of an expression. Now, it can also be used for something that we could argue as perfect returning, if you will. Now, this doesn't make a whole lot of sense in this not generic code, so just be aware of that. So we've now caused a little bit of a problem for ourselves because we are getting a auto return type deduction here, and it's going to follow these normal rules of auto that we expect it to. So this is no longer a const int reference. It is now just a plain int. But if I were to use decltype auto, then I am going to get this perfect forwarding, if you will, of the return type from the wrapped function. And before you ask, yes, you can use trailing return types here if you are so inclined. I don't love this particular use of a trailing return type because I kind of want that visibility that this is decltype auto return here. And also, if you are curious, you can in fact explicitly say that you want the implicitly returned type to be auto deduced, and you can do that. Again, I strongly don't recommend this particular method. But while we're here, let's go ahead and just return the value 1. And in this case, we're back to getting an int returned from our function because we are returning 1. And if I were to do this, then I'm still getting an int returned. And again, still an int returned. Now, where this can get you in trouble, if you're not paying attention, although the compiler will catch this for you for sure, is this is still returning an int. See, it's an int, it's an int. Everyone agrees it's an int. However, this is an L value. It is a local variable. If I were to do this, I've basically just turned this into an expression. And now the return type becomes a int reference. And I can prove that here, but fortunately the compiler is catching us. Fortunately, because I have warnings turned on and I am treating warnings as errors, so this is easily caught for me. Now, if you're not careful with enabling warnings in your code, it will not be caught for you. So yeah, decltype auto, as I already said, deduces the exact type of an expression. Very useful in generic code. Useful for something that could be described as perfect returning of the exact thing that was returned from your function. And just for the record, I actually teach in my best practices class that you should never treat return as a function call, because you might accidentally create this kind of situation, which you would not want to do. So yeah, thanks for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you learned something about decltype auto. It is definitely a useful, interesting utility in the case of generic code. Generally, probably not used very much outside of that situation. So be sure to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up, and check out all the links and such in the video description.